sketching, doing it on paper, going back and forth to the computer, and refining the details a little bit every time to get everything just right.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and then you hit the bell again, so you get the little parentheses around it. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video. Don't forget to check out the design and making merch just below the video. All kinds of stuff, t-shirts, hoodies, and other miscellaneous fun things you might like. Recently, I've been working on a very interesting toilet paper holder. It's a stamped sheet metal product that I designed for Holden Art out of Colorado, and it uses some very interesting magnetic technology. Let me explain. Cleverly hidden inside of this toilet paper holder are a series of detented magnets, and this allows you to precisely remove exactly the amount of toilet paper sheets that you want. One-handed, no less. Currently, the project's on Kickstarter until the end of January 2019. Link below, go check it out and support the project. In those two discs are a series of magnets. You can see in that image right there. We're going to place the magnets so that they repel each other, and those magnets are alternating, and that's what gives us the detents. We can set the strength of the detents by changing the spacing. This is how that's done on the actual toilet paper holder. That's what the knob is for, to set how strong it is to pull, depending upon single ply or double ply sheets that you have. I start this project just like any other, although I did go to IKEA and spend a ton of time just researching how to mount things onto walls and things like that. Ultimately, this project ended up being self-adhesive mounted so that it can be easily mounted anywhere. But I do a ton of sketches in the very beginning. This is probably the first sketch that actually looks close to what the final product is. Simple, clean, and elegant. These are the sketches that were phase one design concepts that were presented to Holden Art at the very beginning of the project. Sometimes when you're designing a product, you don't know what the final production process is going to be. Sometimes you're designing for a specific production method, and sometimes you figure that out as you're moving along in your project. I knew from the get-go, because it had been stated by the client that they wanted the final product to be metal. So I designed for that metal process, either stamped or some sort of a tubing that was manipulated, but it had to be sheet metal in the end, and the product was designed to be a sheet metal product from the get-go. As everybody knows, I'm a pretty hands-on kind of guy, so after those initial ideation sketches that you saw in the beginning, those concepts that were presented to the client, I really wanted to see what those folded and twisted sheet metal forms would look like. And I built a series of cardboard mock-ups so that I could visualize, also for the scale, and to see what that would look like in the actual form when those forms were twisted. And so here you can see me building and mocking up some of those concepts out of some mat board. And if you watch some of my other videos about cardboard mock-ups, you'll get to see some of these processes. So here's the final mock-ups that were then presented to Holden Art so that we could take a look at these concepts. And we liked the fact that they were sheet metal and had some wonderful surfaces, but we wanted to simplify those concepts even more. So a lot of these nice twisted surfaces went by the wayside, and things were dramatically simplified, so they were much more easily manufacturable. And here you can really start to see what the final product is starting to look like. We'll get into some early CAD mock-ups here, where we take that space in the top that would have been wasted and we turn that into an additional functional item. In this case, it's a phone holder. So you're getting additional functionality at no additional cost. And that's only going to help you sell the product by having more features. Here it is in Fusion 360, mocked up or modeled. I modeled this up. I mainly worked on the folded sheet metal look and feel. My client handled some of the mechanical stuff on the inside with the magnets and the wire bending stuff. Wasn't super concerned about that, as that's not seen a lot. I'm more concerned with the exterior and the cosmetics of the final fit and finish of the unit. Here's also a quick sketch of how originally I thought the detents could be adjusted inside the unit. Ultimately, we didn't go that route. Here's some final CAD renderings right out of Fusion 360. And we're going to build a mock-up here so we can kind of see what this thing is going to look like. Now, in the beginning, the magnets were adjusted in a different kind of way. You can see there's kind of a stepped little shelf here that you rotate the outside knob to change the distance between the magnets to set the tension. And this was fine in the very beginning, but ultimately we ditched this concept for the final way it is right now. We wanted something visually a little bit cleaner than what you see right here. And this is how this worked, and you could see the magnets move closer and farther away. But it just wasn't clean enough for what we did. And then ultimately I did this sketch here where we internalized this adjustment through a series of steps that are all hidden, and we use some bearings as well for that. Here you can see an early version of the exploded view where we step up and step down, and all that stuff is internal, and so you don't see that stepping on the outside of the product. This is the second 3D printed prototype, and you can see the phone holder here easily holds the phone. The look is much cleaner since we don't have that step on the outside of the knob there. And then the prototypes start rolling in. This is the very first aluminum base part that was handled by my client. He took care of all the prototyping. And then this is with some machined parts. Looks super jet age here. I'm a big fan of this look. And so this was the first working prototype that we made of the toilet paper holder. And here it is, wall mounted with some VHB. So VHB, for those of you guys don't know, is very high bond. It's an adhesive that's made by 3M. It's basically a super, super strong sticky sticker. And this is how you would mount this in your wall. And there's no worries about this thing coming off. It's pretty strong. This is a little parts breakout, so you can see the bearings for the adjustability. It's all built right into the sheet metal part, simplifying the manufacturability and construction of the unit. And this is a little demo of how things work. You saw that in the very beginning. You can hold the phone horizontal or vertical, pulling those sheets one-handed to whatever length you want. Super easy to change the roll, of course, as well, just like on any other toilet paper holder. At this point, we're into the CMF process, so the color materials and finish process. Probably went through a good dozen different physical mock-ups with different finishes on them. Ultimately, the client chose a powder-coated finish over the anodized finish. It did soften the edges a little bit, and I think that that's a nice thing. Adds a little bit more of a human touch, so there's no chance of the raw sheet metal edge cutting you or anything like that. Itself safely hidden underneath the powder coating, and provides a wonderful bright color finish for most modern bathrooms. This project was pretty standard in length, probably took about 5 or 6 months from initial sketch all the way to production or pre-production prototypes. Again, currently on Kickstarter. Feel free to go check it out and support the campaign. My client would love it. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You can do that by clicking on the icon in the bottom right of the video or below the video. Give it a thumbs up and follow the channel there as well. You want to know about upcoming design content and projects that I'm working on? Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and my favorite Google+. Links below. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.